At Sky Harbor Airport, it seems as if everyone is on their cell phone, but as soon as we get on the plane, of course, the phones, they have to go off. In other parts of the world, it just doesn't work that way. S3TV's Patty Kirkpatrick tells us some are now wondering why things aren't running differently here.
Well, I really don't know what complications it caused with flights, which I think is very important.
And that, says aviation expert and attorney at Gordon Reese, Tim McCullough, is the reason most Americans assume they have to turn off their cell phones and other devices on a plane.
There have been some reports about cell phones and other electronic devices interfering with the avionics.
McCullough says Boeing has tried to duplicate problems, but even using the same devices has never been able to.
The avionics that are in the front that the pilots pay attention to, in order for them to be certified, they have to be hardened against interference.
In fact, the equipment is designed to withstand even lightning strikes to the plane. However, McCullough says there is a more compelling safety issue.
The flight attendants union also doesn't want cell phones to be used during when they're giving their briefings, because they really want the passengers to pay close attention to those briefings. And those briefings are important, because if the airplane crashes, people have very little time to save themselves from any sort of aircraft crash.
And while some passengers do seem to feel the model in Europe that allows virtually unlimited in-flight use is good,
I think most people want to communicate when they're in the air since they have so much time.
Yeah.
I think it's a good idea.
I think it's rather important to have the communication that we're able to have.
Others are not so sure.
I think it's distracting. It's really too close to be having such a conversation, private conversation.
I just don't care to listen to myself or anybody else have a conversation on telephone while I'm on a four-hour flight.
And McCullough says those passengers have a strong, if perhaps unlikely, ally, cell phone companies themselves.
But I think the carriers are going to resist that fiercely.
First, there would be costly changes to cell towers.
They would have to put another receiving device so there was on the top of the tower facing straight up.
And even more expensive, lost bandwidth.
If somebody's using a cell phone in an airplane, it can set off a bunch of the cells, and it costs the carriers a lot of extra money because a lot of channels get taken up.
McCullough says he thinks safety questions and cost concerns will be more than enough to disconnect any efforts to allow cell phone use in flight.
I don't think cell phones are ever going to be allowed on aircraft. I just don't think that's going to happen.
Well, McCullough believes if any electronic devices are allowed on during takeoff and landing, it will be e-readers, something like that. The FAA commissioning a new study now to look at how devices might affect the plane's avionics.